Hey, welcome to In the Den with Dr. Jen, a saucy and open-minded place to explore sexuality in a holistic manner and start thinking about female sexuality outside the box. A particularly controversial topic that unfortunately never seems to die as a controversy is that of sex education for teenagers. And that is our Den Chat topic today with special guest and very good friend, Andrea Callahan. Andrea received her BS in human biology and is currently pursuing a master's in public health and a master's in Latin American studies at San Diego State University. She also currently works full-time as a reproductive health educator and guest speaker on reproductive health issues in high schools throughout the North County of San Diego. And the best part, teenagers call her the condom lady.
That's right.
So in my experience around teens and sociologically, I really think teenagers get a lot of contradictory messages when it comes to sex. What do you think of that and what do you do about that?
I definitely agree with you. We find that when we're talking to teens that they tend to receive their messages about sex from five major sources that include media, their family, their friends, their religion, and then society in general. Each of those messages can be very mixed, or each of those sources can have very different mixed messages. So when we come into a classroom and we're talking to teens, trying to give them accurate information can sometimes be a challenge because they've heard from their parents or from other sources that condoms aren't effective and that birth control is going to do really bad things to you, and so many different messages. So what we try to do is to just give them all the accurate information that we can, and then that allows them to make healthy decisions about sex.
And you think they're trusting you and believing you?
I think they are. I think it kind of get them warmed up, and the first day is kind of building that relationship with them and building that trust, and then after that they seem to warm up and believe what you're saying.
Nice. Okay, so there's sort of a rapport building.
Yes, exactly.
That makes sense. So what specifically do you think are the most valuable messages for teenage girls, since this show is about female sexuality?
It's actually really difficult in the classroom sometimes because they're co-ed. Uh-huh. And generally the girls are outnumbered, so the guys tend to dominate the conversation and it turns into all about them. Uh-huh. So that's really a challenge. But I do talk to a lot of teens outside of school, and when it's one-on-one and I'm speaking to the girls, they have a lot of concerns, but they are listening, they are paying attention to all these things. So as far as messages go, in the context of what I do, I think that it's really important for girls in relationships to know if they are going to be sexually active, that there are resources out there for them. A lot of teens that I talk to aren't using any form of protection to protect themselves against pregnancy and STIs. So I think it's important for them to know that there are places where they can go and they can access free and confidential reproductive health services.
Okay, so their family doctor doesn't have to know, their parents don't have
Correct.
To know, nobody has to know.
Yeah,
okay.
Nobody will say a thing.
Okay, so where, for example, could they find this information if they were looking for it?
So in the state of California, teens could go to the website www.familypact.org, and they could find a list of clinics in their area that would offer these free services.
Oh, nice. And then overall, probably something like Planned Parenthood at least, maybe.
Yeah, Planned Parenthood could be a good starting point.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And I mentioned controversial when I first brought up this topic, and something that's been in the news recently in New Jersey in the public schools is controversy around having juniors and seniors teaching freshmen sex education. What do you think about that?
I think it's a great idea. I think teens are going to relate better to somebody who is similar in age to them if they had the choice between somebody in their age range or having somebody their parents' age teach them about sex. They're going to learn more from a younger person. As far as this particular case, I think parents are just worried in general about their teens learning about sex because, of course, they think that by knowing about sex and learning about sex, their teen is then going to have sex, which we haven't seen any evidence of that.
That's not what the research shows.
Yeah, so...
I don't know. Well, and I think an important point too is that, I mean, peer education is a standard part of sex education or HIV prevention for people of any age, and that they're trained. And I mean, you've dealt with students before, and you're there as they're teaching the younger yes. students, right? They're yeah. being overseen. They've been trained. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've yeah. had experience with a program similar to the one in New Jersey, where teens come in with an educator, and they present on a few different topics. So somebody is there supervising. They can answer questions or clear anything up that wasn't quite accurate. But I think that teens respond really well to
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I think so too. Okay, and our final question, which is our randomly generated gorilla soapbox question is, oh, where in nature have you most enjoyed having sex?
All right, let's see. Okay, I'm gonna have to say the beach.
Nice.
And not provide too many details.
Was there at least a blanket? Because the sand.
There was a blanket.
Logistically can be problematic, yeah. but it was nice.
It was good.
It was good. Well, thank you so much, Andrea, for being here today and for all really the much needed work that you're doing in sex education. Thank you. Sexual fun fact number 409.
What percentage of American women own no undergarments? Is it A, 1%, B, 4%, C, 8%, or D, 13%.
Answer? B, 4% of women are always free burden. You go, girl. How about you, Andrea?
No comment.
The 10 recommend. You've probably heard of Alfred Kinsey, the Kinsey Institute, or research by Kinsey. But have you seen the movie Kinsey? If you're interested in knowing more about the story behind this sex research, particularly in the 1940s and 1950s, and some of the foundational sex research that's been done in the past 100 years, then check out this movie. Great acting, compelling storyline, great cultural account of the time.
Hello. I'm Dr. Alfred Kinsey from Indiana University, and I'm making a study of sex behavior. What's your most common decision?
There's more than one?
I've learned that the gap between what we assume people do sexually and what they actually do is enormous.
How young were you when you first experienced hugging?
Necking.
Petting.
What did you dream about?
That's why a study of this kind is so important. All we have is what people like you are willing to share with us.
Does suppressing
two or three times?
No, only once.
A day.
I think about my cat.
Lead to stuttering?
A lot.
So, if you're sitting comfortably there, let's begin. In an uninhibited society, a 12-year-old would know most of the biology, which I will have to give you in formal lectures.
Dr. Kinsey's findings are shocking.
Are you surprised at the success of your book?
No, it shows that the world has wanted this done.
And Dr. Kinsey.
Hear, hear, hear.
Hoover is still annoyed that you won't help him find homosexuals in the State Department.
It's advisable to stick to what's normal. You don't want to shake people up.
Of course not.
What did you expect?
The enforcers of chastity are massing once again.
What are we to you? Just lab rats? Is this just another part of the project?
Stop using science to justify what you've done.
Forgive me, Mac.
I've taken on so many other people's secrets. I don't want any of my own.
Haven't I always been open to whatever you wanted?
Sex is a risky game because if you're not careful, it will cut you wide open.
You saved my life, sir.
You just told me your entire history, but there hasn't been a single mention of love.
Love is the answer, isn't it? But sex raises a lot of very interesting questions.
And the problems he starts to have with funding and a conservative environment is quite reflective of our current environment around sex education. It's becoming more and more difficult in recent years to get funding for solid sex research. Taphophilia.
What's that word mean?
Well, taphophilia is being aroused through being buried alive. Yeah, I know, like, and I don't mean to be judgmental here, but that sounds terrifying. And how do you find out that you have an attraction and arousal like that? I don't know. Fascinating. I own undergarments. What about you? Visit me at drchensden.com or email me at jennifer@drchensden.com. And are you a fan of this show? Do you like what we're doing? You think this information's valuable? We'd love your donation. Thank you to those that have donated already. And the rest of you, we've got a button on the website. Thank you, Andrea. And we're also looking for sponsors to be able to keep doing what we're doing here at Gorilla Soapbox, because we love entertaining and educating you. So we definitely need to talk more about sex with everyone. And be kind to yourself.
That'd be fun.
That would be a lot
I'll be somebody
fun.
Else. Can I wear the hooker boots?